Us.
The So Mixed Up Podcast, episode 8. That means it's, what, been 2 months now, like, on some official stuff?
Whoa.
Ooh.
Has it been 2 months?
I mean, 8 episodes.
I guess, yeah.
You know. So, how's it going?
It's going good. How are you?
I'm good. I just scared you like 5 minutes ago, so I'm feeling pretty on top of myself. You know.
Whatever.
You're pretty scared. You almost cried, so.
I didn't cry.
I said almost. Did you almost cry?
I did not almost cry. I was scared, and then I got mad, so there's a difference.
She almost cried, y'all. Anyway.
Oh, hush.
So, yeah, episode 8. Thank you guys for continuing to listen and your support. We appreciate it always.
Yeah. Also, watch the video, too.
Yeah, watch the video, listen, all of that good stuff, you know, because we So Mixed Up on YouTube. That's So Space Mixed Up together. I had to think about it. I really had to think about it.
That was a brain fart.
Got no one art.
It's
Instagram.
Light, too.
It's so, underscore right there, yeah. So I had to think about it. But yes.
Well, tell them, baby, we got a new Instagram just for our podcast.
Oh, yeah, Instagram just for the podcast. And it's So Mixed Up Podcast on Instagram, so you can check that out. Get a couple snippets of the episodes as we post them and, you know, get a good feel about what we're going to be talking about.
So just follow us on all
Follow us everywhere. I mean, we're so mixed up everywhere, so just look it up. You know, you'll find us. You'll see our faces.
Did we ever tell them why we named it So Mixed Up?
Pretty sure we did on YouTube. I don't know about on here.
Yeah.
Go ahead, tell them.
I forgot the reason why we named it.
you named it.
Did I name it? I thought, no. Nah, okay. Yeah, so we're so mixed up because we're a mixed couple.
Look how she conveniently just remembered why she named it so mixed up.
You can't put me on the spot and then expect me not to remember, okay? That's how it rolls.
So why?
I just said because we're a mixed couple. That's what we named it.
It's so bland. It just sounded whack.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. My tone of voice.
Like, yeah, we did it because we're a mixed couple. Yeah, anyway.
Anywho.
So, yeah, that's why we named ourselves so mixed up. You brought up the topic and then you was all dry about it.
I'm sorry, babe. I'm a little dry, okay?
Yeah, when she says 30 things, we fist pump. Because that's not fist pump, fist bump.
Yes.
Fist pumping, that's weird. We're not in a club.
I mean, we could be. We could be in the club.
Club, I don't know. Club quarantine.
Yeah. Club quarantine. I'm just kidding.
Oh, that was a little much. So, you started a new job this
week.
So, how did it go? How was it?
It was long. It was terrible. I'm just kidding. People that. Lauren, if you're listening to this, it was great. Mm-hmm. You tell everybody at work it was great. Great first couple of days of training. It was good. It was, the days were super long. I'm not used to them. I'm used to only working about 4.5 hours because I am still in school. So it was a change to get trained at 7:30 in the morning. I was not happy for that.
That's because you weren't trying to sleep. She wanted to be up. I'm a bad influence on the guys.
You are.
She used to couldn't make it to midnight. Now she's up to like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning every night. And I'm like, why are you up?
Yes.
She used to go to sleep early.
Yes.
I miss it.
You're so mean. You took that away. You took my innocence.
I was so used to just coming home from work and you be sleeping and then now she's be up. She's like, hey babe, hi, hey babe. I'm like, why are you woke? This is me time.
So Now I know how you truly feel. But no, at first it was because I was watching The Vampire Diaries, so I started staying up for that. Now I'm at the last season, and you refuse for me to keep watching without you.
Because I want to watch the last few episodes with you. I want to see who lives, who dies.
So now I have to like. Ending. So now I have to like put a whole big pause on watching Vampire Diaries. Yeah, the season of Vampire Diaries, let's talk about it now since, you know,
got on
the
top. Yeah, we haven't talked about it in a couple of weeks, so.
I definitely enjoyed last season a lot more. It was season 7.
Last season, that was the one with the heretics and the, you know.
Yes, that was a good one. I liked that, the whole.
Well, then that was season 6. Season 7 was the one with the time going forward and back and all that.
Yeah. Yeah. And then this season, they have the sirens because there's two of them. But at first,
yeah, you like how it took so long to drop that second one. He was like, oh crap.
I know, I'm like, because they kept talking about it, and then it was only, they only showed one person, and then all of a sudden there was two of them. I'm like, oh wow. I guess I can spoil it because, you know,
yeah,
people aren't really, I don't think they're watching it anymore. But if you are, I'm pretty sure.
I mean, it aired 10 years ago, so.
Yeah.
If you haven't caught up, sorry.
Sorry. Apparently, one of the siren is the nanny of Caroline Ford. And their also last season, was it? Yeah, last season she gave birth to twins that were put into her body, and those two twins are basically witches. Mm-hmm. And they're both little girls, but they're also Alaric's kids because he was about to get married to his wife, but then they killed the wife, and she was apparently pregnant with twins, and they just transferred those into Caroline, and then she gave birth to them, so now she's mom. It's a little confusing. When I was like, wait, what? So
we won't bore you guys with a lot of details. But okay, so predictions for the end. Short, give me a quick sentence on what, how you think it's going to end.
Well, now Stefan is not a vampire because he got what is it called?
It's just called the cure.
Yeah, the cure. I know, but like for some reason I couldn't think of the word cure. So he's not a vampire anymore. I just feel like he may die now because he's not a vampire. And
that's your prediction?
He's going to die. And I predicted Enzo, he died. And Bonnie's just going to be miserable. So that's how that's going to end. Bonnie's just going to be miserable. Stefan's going to die.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good predictions. But anyway, that was a tangent.
Yeah.
Diet office. How do you like it?
Oh yeah, the call center. I do like it. It's definitely a lot harder to adjust to it, just because there's a little bit more pressure on my end. Because I was so used to before I got into the call center, I was a tray passer, which just basically means that I deliver the meals to the patients. And now I am in the call center, and I just basically am taking the orders, but you have more responsibilities because you have to make sure that they don't have allergies, they have a regular diet, there's different diets that are throughout the hospital, so it's just like making sure that you're basically on top of your game and not effing up. Mm-hmm. So definitely a lot of more brain work, and it's different because as tray passer, I would walk the whole hospital and my feet would hurt. And now, like, my butt hurts because I sit down for a lot of my shift and I'm like, I need to move. I can't sit down for a while. But everybody's telling me that that's just part of the job. You just got to get used to sitting down. And I'm like, I can't be in office. My eyeballs hurt after a while.
Yeah, you'll get used to it. It's only been, what, four days now?
Yeah.
So you'll get used to it.
But for the most part, it's not bad. Definitely a different change. Definitely more responsibilities than what I was doing before. So.
Good.
And I don't have to wear a uniform. I get to wear whatever I want to wear.
Ayy. So that's good. Glad you're liking it, at least.
Yeah.
Or, you know.
Trying to.
Yeah.
Keyword is trying to like
trying
the job.
Trying to like it. So, yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, so, well, how did school go? Because you got your grades, so.
Yeah, I passed. I didn't fail. Yay. That's how excited I am about it.
Oh, she sounds so enthusiastic about
school. I know. I mean, just because, like, I barely got a week off. And then I start back summer classes on Monday. So now I'm just like,
That's the life you chose.
I know. That's the life I chose. I didn't want to go to school. Yeah, but, you know, I got a...
couple semesters. Two semesters.
Yeah, I have two semesters. And it's over. Yeah, it was...
So think about it that way.
Yeah.
Now you got one class this summer. You don't have a full load. One class, and it's only a couple weeks.
Yeah, but then it's over. I think I also F myself up because I basically have a full load in the fall. And I'm like, great.
Good. Get it out the way. Get it out the way.
Yeah. So, and I graduate...
December. Was it December 12th or something?
I don't know anymore. I feel like with this whole coronavirus, we don't know what's going to happen.
You might just get your diploma in the mail.
Yeah, basically, they said that I know the people that are graduating in the spring, they just basically email their diploma so that they can print it out. I was like...
That's somebody email me a diploma to print out. I'm raising so much hell. You better at least drop it off at my house or something. I saw some article about... was it Ohio? I feel like it wasn't Ohio. It was a school. I don't know if it was the superintendent or the principal or whatever. Might have been like the largest high school in the country or the largest high school in Ohio.
Was she on like $10,000 or something like that? Or am I thinking about somebody else?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
I was just saying the principal or the superintendent or whoever it was going around actually personally like delivering the diplomas to the houses or whatever. Now it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I don't know what you're talking about, $10,000. What are you talking about?
Well, it was another one that was like a principal from some school and she like got some award for like being the best like principal or something from the school and she got like $10,000. I was like, oh, must be nice.
Oh, no, fuck her. Nah, I haven't heard about that, but I guess congratulations to her for being the best principal and winning money.
Yeah, I guess because she cared about students, not like most principals that like just walk by and barely know your name.
Yeah.
Apparently, she was doing some job. She was doing her job.
Okay, well, she got some extra money for doing her job. Congratulations.
Yeah. Congrats.
So yeah, how do you think the new world order is with things opening back up and trying to get back to life?
Yeah, my coworkers and I were just talking about it, and so on the news, according to Channel 5, they're going to be opening up like restaurants. However, they're going to have outside seating. But they're going to be blocking off some of the roads so that way they can, like, distance the outside seating. But then they also said that if it's too crowded, they're going to call the cops. I don't understand the whole thing. That's where I'm all confused about. Like,
because I guess you have your regular seats. So they're saying if it's too crowded, as in people are just going down there and loitering and not actually sitting at their designated seats, I'm guessing that'll be the issue. Not just people going down there in general, but just if you're down there and you're just in a big old crowd, loitering around the bars or the restaurant, I guess that'll be the issue. Not just people who are actually sitting in the seats that they're given and eating their meals or whatever.
But the thing is, like, you can't really tell people to, like, not walk around, like, if especially because it's off the banks, you know, there's the little park and all the stuff down there. So it's like, how are you going to control people who are actually eating and who's just like walking around? I know.
Because the ones that are eating would be eating, and the ones walking around would be walking around.
I just think that, I don't know. I feel like there should be a better way of doing something, I feel like there needs to be a better planning, because I feel like if you're gonna shut down, I mean, granted, nobody's like going fully back to work yet, and stuff aren't fully opening.
I think the difference between because it's not like the banks were closed in general. Yeah, the restaurants might have been closed, but you could still go down there if you wanted to. So they're just saying, don't have too large of a crowd, or don't be down there trying to party or whatever. You know, I guess they're trying to regulate that if they can.
I mean, also, like, it's been cold. It's May. It's still, it's like, what, yesterday was like 40 something?
Yeah, it got down like to 20 something.
So people are like,
so I don't know why it's so cold.
People wearing like, still wearing hoodies and jackets and all that stuff. And I'm like, it's still a little breezy.
Yeah, wait till we're supposed to be back in the 80s next weekend. So we'll see.
Well, it's going to be 80s and rainy. That's what seems like every time we got high weather.
Yeah, whenever it gets warm, it rains. But I mean, it rains every other day. It's supposed to rain tomorrow. So. So we'll see how it all pans out with everything opening back up. Or not everything, but a lot of things opening back up, but just different rules. Like some things that I've seen open back up is like you only have 10 people in here at one time or here at one time. So, I mean, we'll see how it goes. But I mean, might want to stay inside because, you know, they got the old murder hornets now. So.
Oh, yeah. Let's open. I'm still confused about that. So are they
so concerned about the murder hornets? I'm not worried about a hornet. Yes. Could it kill you? Sure. But am I really just walking around scared that I'm going to be attacked by a swarm of hornets?
But aren't they the... Okay, what I'm understanding is that they don't really go to attack humans. They're going more to attack bees, like the honeybees. Is that what I'm getting?
I think so. Honestly, I haven't done too much research on these.
And I haven't seen one yet. Hornets. I haven't seen one yet, so I'm not sure if they're only... Like, I know that they were in, like, Seattle at first, I think. And then they're starting to travel towards us. Is that the thing?
I don't know. Honestly, I haven't been keeping up on the news of the murder hornets. It's not really...
I mean, have you seen those? The suckers look huge.
I mean, but they look big on a freaking zoomed-in microscope. Microscope, but camera. But, like, if I just see one flying in front of me, will I think it's that big? I don't know. Because we only see, like, the zoomed-up videos and the zoomed-up pictures. But it's like...
I got chills.
Remember our children's, how you get the cicada eaters? Would it be bigger than those cicada eaters?
I've never seen. I've seen the signs of them, but I've never seen.
Those things are huge, and they look freaking scary.
Yeah, I've never seen them.
So if they're not that big, then I'm not too worried. Like if they don't look that big flying at me, then I think I'll be okay.
You're gonna have one flying at you, and you're gonna be like, "Babe, they're huge." I'm like, "I told you. The news told me they were huge."
Yeah, we'll see. I don't see them just going around attacking people though, so I think we'll be all right.
But I just love these like the names they give them. Like you got the cicada killer, and then the hornet, murder hornets,
murder hornet.
But then are they saying that they came from Asia? Is that why?
Something. They came from, you know, a place that they're not normally here, or they've never been here, or something like that. So
my thing is, like, how does one travel that far?
I mean, probably got some islands stopped in between, or it was in some people's luggages, you know?
Oh, that's true. People check your luggage, okay? You got bed bugs out there. You got cockroaches. Ants.
Cockroaches.
You got all that stuff. Check your luggage. Mm-hmm. All times.
Yeah. All times.
At all times. Check your luggage.
Check it again before you're going to check it again.
That's going to be the title of this podcast. Check your luggage.
Check your luggage. Yes, guys, but for real, check your luggage.
Yeah. I know. We're joking about it, but not for real. Like, check your luggage. Take some alcohol spray. Spray it down. Spritz, spritz.
But guys... Well, I guess when you're hearing this, it'll be yesterday, but Mother's Day was yesterday.
Mother's Day tomorrow? Oh, yeah, never mind.
Jesus Christ.
You're right. I bet. Just ignore me. I'm a little tired. It's late.
We try to give a little coof to the podcast to make it seem like you're listening to this in real time. And yeah. I said, yeah, Mother's Day was yesterday. You're like, no, it's tomorrow.
Happy Mother's Day to all the mamas out there. Happy Mother's Day to your mama. Happy Mother's Day to my mama. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there that are doing.
Yes, if you're a mother, happy Mother's Day. If you're taking care of your kids, if you don't give a fuck about your kids, fuck you. So,
but if you care about your kids. I'm not going on that one. That's all, Yahshua.
If you don't care about your kids,
I wasn't gonna say that. That mean.
I'm just saying, not every mother deserves a happy Mother's Day. That's all
true,
I'm saying.
That's true. That's true. There you go, babe.
To the ones that do, happy Mother's Day. If you take care of your children, happy Mother's Day.
Yeah. Also, happy Mother's Day to the moms that are also the fathers. So yeah. When Father's Day comes, you're going to actually happy Father's Day, too.
I'm about to say, like, all right, happy Mother's Day to the fathers that are mothers.
There you go.
How about that?
That's
what you should have said, because...
Whatever.
You can say that on Father's Day, the mothers that are the fathers, too. But on Mother's Day, you'd be like, yeah, the fathers who the moms weren't crap and, you know, and the father is taking care of the kids. Happy Mother's Day to you guys.
They're going to be like, nah, we just give us Father's Day. I feel like.
Give me both.
Nah, give me both.
Any chance so I can get some shit? Give me both.
Give me both. That's my mama. My mom's a happy mother and a happy father.
Yeah, like give me both. Give me all.
She gets all of it.
Birthday.
She gets Grandparents' Day.
Yeah, give me all of it. I could be a grandfather for a day.
just for one day, guys.
Just for one day. Like, yeah. Happy Grandparents' Day. Me?
I got surprised.
You're 28. Yeah, I mean.
Me?
They get younger and younger, don't they? But, yeah. Hope you guys had a good Mother's Day. I know you can't really go to any restaurants and sit down. And I know some of you guys are still social distancing and, you know, aren't seeing your parents or your grandparents. So, hopefully you can...
Stay distance.
Hopefully you can call them and wish them a happy Mother's Day, or send them a card, or, you know, some flowers or whatnot. So that'd be nice.
You know what? I'm going to cut you off.
What'd you get your mother?
I got her a plant.
What?
Yeah, I got her. Well, I showed you. You saw what I got her. So then I got your mama a card and a plant that looks so cute.
A card and a plant.
Yeah. What'd you get in your mama?
I gave her some roses today. Ooh, salty.
Oh, I am salty. What'd you get my mama, your mother-in-law?
I gave my mama some flowers today, some roses.
It wore that. My mom's going to text me. She's like, Yahshua, don't give me no different Mother's Day. I said, look, Ma, I can't help your son-in-law.
See, but what she doesn't know is that I dropped some flowers off to her mama today. Boom.
Boom. Salty.
Salty as balls.
No, just salty. Oh, you know what? I'm a give a shout out to all those people that are following the rules and staying inside and making sure they're washing their hands. Shout out to those people. You know why? Because people are not.
You seem very passionate about that. Have you seen some people not washing their hands?
Yes,
something?
I actually have. And it's quite disgusting. And people that cover their coughs properly and not using just their hands.
Ooh, I know something that I wanted to say before I forget, because we didn't write it down. The baby shower, the baby's birthday, not in and of itself, but I felt like the idea that they had for the birthday was pretty dope. About Keegan.
Oh, okay.
About writing the note.
I was like, I'm confused.
Like, okay, so they told us to come with like a letter written to the child, which is, her name's Keegan. She's about to turn one, and I guess they're gonna like seal it away, like this kind of time capsule type of thing. And they're not gonna give it to her until her 18th birthday. So everyone who attends the party is gonna like write a letter whatever.
Okay, before I'm gonna cut you off real quick, that is your best friend's daughter.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that sounds pretty dope. Which, to be honest with you, Kristen, if you're listening, I'm stealing an idea for our kid's first birthday as well, because that's pretty freaking dope. I read that and I was like, oh, that is pretty amazing.
Yeah, that's I think dope. It's awesome. And that's because I also liked it because she's like, so make it count. For me, it's going to be awkward because I don't know her like that.
Hey, your mom seems cool.
I was like, your mom is my husband's best friend and they share the same birthday.
Yeah, that's my other twin.
Cool.
Got a few twins out there.
Yeah, you do.
Got a real twin.
You do.
I got my best friend twin. I have a cousin that's a twin.
Nice. Boom.
So I got like, I share my birthday with four different people that I actually know in my life, which is weird.
I mean, I share a birthday with a celebrity. Does that count?
That don't count at all.
Okay, cool.
You don't know them. What celebrity?
It's the...
I'd be somebody that no way knows. She's going to be some...
Hodges some from Bones.
Telenova person.
you're so hilarious. Ha.
It's going to be our board just fell. It's going to be Eric Estrada from Chips. Well, he was on Chips, right?
No.
Eric Estrada? I don't know. But who is it again? What did you say? Who was?
I said it was Hodges from Bones. We shared.
Hodges. That's the one with the curly hair, right?
Yep. Okay. His name is TJ.
He ended up being a paraplegic on that show. So, I mean, watch yourself. Watch yourself.
What? You watch yourself. I mean, if y'all watching this YouTube live video, you just saw me jump because the board fell. So
she's a security cat, but it's okay.
Look, I've scared you a couple times, and Mr. I never get scared. I go, I've got, you know, I got it on video too.
She's
so,
got me a couple times, but I mean, who's gotten who way, 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 way more?
You just tried too much. That's what
I could just
is.
Jump at you right now. You'd be like, oh.
No, I wouldn't.
I mean, not now. You know what's coming, but if I just like lunged at you, you'd be like,
Nah, I'll be afraid I'm gonna get hit. That's,
I mean, you just jumped at the board falling. So
because it's unexpectedly and it fell.
Did I jump?
You just don't jump.
I heard it here first, folks. I don't jump. But
your heart be racing, that's all.
No, it's not.
Just let me have something, geez.
Okay, yeah, my heart's racing and I was terrified. I think I pissed myself a little bit.
Dang, you just can't let your wife have something. You just gotta be like, nah, denied. Access denied.
I mean, from a lie, sure. I could just be like, yeah, you got me and I was so scared. But if you want me to be honest and truthful with you.
Whatevs.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Anyway, nothing really happened this week, guys. We're not gonna lie. We're struggling this podcast because we have nothing to talk about.
Yeah, we didn't really go out. Women who can't go out.
I ain't do nothing. I DoorDash today. That's about the only extracurricular thing that I've done.
I got trained, and that's the only extracurricular thing I did. I tried to use that word, but I can't quite. That's
the only extracurricular, Papa.
Words are hard for me, okay, guys? What are you going to say, babe? Say it.
I was going to blame it on the Spanish, but I'm like, nah, you learned English first.
Actually, no, I had Spanish first and then English.
Okay.
So.
Barely.
You don't know my life.
I know enough.
Nah.
But, yeah, so we don't have much to talk about, guys. Instead of letting these jokes fly. But, yeah, I feel like we started off short. Then we got longer because we got the hang of it. It was a lot to talk about. But today, there's nothing to really talk about.
You know, we can be like the Joe Budden show. You know, he'd be like, we don't
got to give you guys an hour and a half every time. You know what I mean? We can just give you guys a quick 30.
Nah, the first time we gave him 30, I was like, whatever. And then we were just like, nah, we got stuff to say. But, yeah, but honestly, nothing really happened today. This week.
Well. First of all, we're going to take a little break. This is where the sponsors would go if we had one. But we don't. Wink, wink. Catalog. But hold up, yo. Step back. Boom. Did it start yet? Boom. There we go. See, it takes forever. And these are for the YouTube exclusive. Hey, y'all. How y'all doing out there? Hey, you.
Yeah,
sitting
you
over there. Pick it up out your chair.
I can't go with you, babe.
That's okay. We're gonna just turn the podcast back
let's
on
go,
now.
Let's go.
Yeah.
And we're back. What's up, West Coast? I think we're on the East Coast, right?
Did you just say we're not on any coast?
Oh.
Do you see an ocean around here?
Just let me have it. Just every time.
We are in what they call the Midwest.
Okay, whatever. Midwest. Woo. Wisconsin cheese. Woo. That's what I think about when I hear the word.
You hear Midwest, you just think Wisconsin cheese?
Yes, I do. Is that a problem?
I'm sorry, guys. I'm working on her. But
there's nothing to work about, okay?
How did the diet go this week?
Food-wise, good. I'm a little bloated because, time of the month is happening. So I'm a little bloated. I can tell by my face.
That's just what women say when they don't. Continue. What happened?
How is yours?
So you were bloated?
Yeah. How was your stuff?
I did all right. Nah, I messed up a little bit this week, but it was cool. I just felt like I felt like we were eating all right, but I felt like I didn't eat enough meals this week.
Yeah.
Put it that way. I didn't eat enough meals to where, like, I could eat and then be full and then not eat. I did a lot of snacking this week, and I don't like to snack a lot because, I don't know, it's pointless. Empty calories, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just eating to eat. When you snack, you're not going to get full from snacking. If you're eating, like, it could be healthy, but you're snacking. Like, if I eat a bunch of fruit cups or a bunch of applesauce or a bunch of veggie chips, like, I'm never going to get full off of that. So then I'm going to just keep snacking and keep snacking, keep snacking. But if I eat a meal, I'll at least get full. So I do feel like I did a lot of snacking this week, so that attributed to me not losing any weight. I think I gained, like, 2 pounds or something like that, so.
Yeah, I gained about 4.
So, but Monday.
That's a lot of but.
It's just 3.
Oh, okay, just again, not letting me have it. Dang.
I mean, I'd like for you to be accurate, baby. I'm just trying to help you, okay? But
accurate, schmaculate.
They didn't even rhyme.
I don't care. Rhyme to me, okay?
It said smaccurate. He's like, accurate smack. I don't know what you said, actually.
See, you don't even know, so you can't even correct
me. We are going to get into our workout groove Monday. We have all our workouts written down. They're posted on the wall, so we can just get to it. So, yeah, that'll be fun. Not fun, but, we'll see the results of the workout, and then we're
adjusted. No, working out is fun.
No, not for me. But
babe, working out is fun. We got to motivate people. We got to eat right. We got to work out. We got to eat right, and we got to work out. Yeah. Get them pumped. Eat right and then work out.
Hey, you.
Okay, I'm done.
Sitting over there. Better get up out your chair. But, I forgot what I was saying.
You said we're going to start working out.
Yeah, we're starting to work out Monday. So we have our workouts written down. We're going to get to it. And we'll see the results of that plus our diet and see how that goes.
Yeah.
Because I do want to keep losing the weight. And we got to take our pictures. That's what we got to
do. Oh, yeah. You did. You got to tell them.
I want to take a picture at least once or twice a week of ourselves and
naked.
And not naked. Well, shirtless, like our body pictures. And then we'll.
I'm going to be wearing some shorts and a bra, okay?
I'm not going to be naked because what I'm trying to do with it, I can't just be out here naked. So,
I mean, we could.
We could. Then that'll be a different video. You know what I mean? That'd be
we can't have that.
One of those band sites, one of those XXX sites.
OnlyFans?
Oh, yeah. Tune into our OnlyFans.
to see it,
we'll start off at, what is it, $6 or something?
We
cheap out here.
Nah, I'm going to start with 25. I don't know about you, 25? But I'm starting with 25.
All right, yeah. We can get like 7 people to do 25 a month. Like, that's pretty dope. That's pretty dope.
I'll shake it for them, too. I'll be like,
I'm glad that's on video. but yeah, I want to do that at least once or twice a week. And we'll edit the pictures with like our current weight at the time. And we'll have it like that. And when we get to a point to where we're satisfied, we'll cut it down to like a video where the pictures go like fast. And you see our transformation as we go. So when we get to the weight that we're maybe not our goal weight, but when we're satisfied with how we look, then we'll, you know, put that out there. Put it on YouTube. So Mixed Up. YouTube, Instagram, So Mixed Up Podcast, Instagram as well.
There's a lot of Instagram. There's a lot of So Mixed Up. Just you'll find us somewhere in the social media world. Yes.
But yeah, I'm excited about doing that. Holding myself to the fire in a way of, you know, making sure that my pictures have progress.
I've never heard that before, but
putting myself to the fire.
No, you said holding myself to the fire.
I'm pretty sure that's the same.
No, holding myself accountable.
I mean, you got that, but why do you sound so freaking Latin when you said that? Say it again. Holding myself accountable? Like, you had like an accent when you said it. I was like, what was that? All of a sudden, she just tapped into her Latin roots. Holding myself accountable? Like, do it again. You had an accent with it. It was weird.
No. Can't do it now. I'm gonna mess it up because you're gonna be like, oh wow.
You definitely had an accent.
No, I just said hold myself accountable.
You didn't say it like that.
No, I'll say it again when I'm not thinking about it.
You definitely had a little Latin twang.
Just you know, replay it and see if I have it.
I know we're gonna let us do it, but
you're gonna be like, aha, yeah. You do have a Latin.
But holding myself to the fire or something like that. It's the same. I promise.
I'm gonna let you
But yeah, so we're excited. I'm still excited. I can't wait to start working out. I mean, I can, but we need to get it done. So we're gonna start working out. And be sore.
I think I talked about it last week about why we kind of pushed off the working out. I think I did on this podcast.
Yeah, I can't remember. I think you said why you held us back from working out.
Yeah. And you see me, I agree. So I was like,
whoa. I was all like, we start working out, babe. Like, well, I want to wait till the diet gets in, you know, we get good with the eating. I got it. But, you know, it was definitely your idea, though. It was.
Yes, of course. Because, like, I know myself. If I start to do too many things at once, let's see, karma's a bitch.
That hurt. But go ahead.
That's what you get. Nah, I'm gonna laugh it out. See, you start talking, you try to throw me under the fire. I said, karma's like, here you go, bitch.
Got fire in him. Hey, I thought I was throwing you under the bus.
That's what you said. Throw you under what?
You said throw you under the fire. That's what you said.
See you.
Anyways,
see, that's your fault. You got me saying throwing fire and throwing wind. Yeah, we're still recording. So
okay, but yeah, go ahead. Tell them why.
I forgot. I was trying to. Oh yeah. Because I know myself. I know that like if I start to do too many things at once, I'm gonna fall off. So I wanted to start getting the eating right. You know, cooking and making sure that we're snacking properly and making sure that we have good clean food in our systems, and just at least give us 2 weeks of doing that and do it on a regular basis so that we're not just like, of course, the first week you're on the diet, you're like, yeah, I did great, and then second week you're like, oh, you know, I kind of messed up. So I kind of wanted us to be consistent at least for 2 weeks and then start throwing in the workouts. So that way we get the full blown bam, jam, chicken jam.
Man, me, I'm just like, let's do it all at once. Let's just go hard. But I get it.
And then what happens when...
I get it.
But gosh. No. I'm all, excuse me.
Man, look at you, nasty. Go, Tino. Hey, T-Fam. Go, you heard that, T-Fam.
It's Cochina. Say it right. Whatever. You got to use the feminine and masculine words properly.
So silly. In English, it's just one word.
I know.
Nasty. I don't know. Nasto. Nasty. Like, no, it's just one word.
I know, but we're difficult. We like to have different words for different meanings, okay?
Yeah, whatevs.
whatevs.
But yeah, I get it. So either way, I'm excited to start working out Monday after this cheat day coming up tomorrow. Boom, 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 boom. What we doing, babe? You said pizza? Hey.
Yeah.
That's what you wanted. You looked confused. Like, did I say pizza? Like, that's what you wanted.
I know. I was like, did I say pizza this week? I don't know.
You could change it up if you wanted to, but you said pizza.
I think I also said, like, I wanted some, like, loaded fries with some steak and guac and sour cream.
You did, but I'm not making that.
I know.
So I ain't gonna hold you. I'm not doing it. I'm trying to get some DoorDash in tomorrow, and the loaded fries, honey, is gonna take me, like, 2 hours to make. I'm not about that life tomorrow. So yeah,
you said nah.
Not about that life tomorrow.
I didn't say you had to make it. I said I could have made it.
But you're gonna be at work.
True.
Yeah. So yeah, peace it is.
Peace it is. Ooh, some garlic bread. Ooh, that sounds good.
Yeah, write down what you want so I know, because yeah.
See, you can't ask me, like, when I'm about to be on my period, a lot of stuff goes out the window. I'll be like, I want some french fries from one spot, cheese on some other spot, you know?
Yeah, we're not doing that.
Exactly. No,
take it easy. Easy like Sunday morning. Rest in peace, Bill Withers. But, yes. The hell is that?
Somewhere talking outside?
Oh, maybe. I'm like, I never heard noises in this apartment before. I'm like, what the hell is that?
Oh,
like,
man, who is talking? I hear noises all the time when I'm by myself. I'm like,
I'm just like, I hear a whole voice. I'm like, who is talking right now? Yeah, I guess it's coming from outside. Either way, I mean, either it's ghosts and we die, or it's voices outside. I don't know. Whatever.
This might be our.
Or it's voices outside and we die. I mean, either way. This might be the last time you hear. Well, it's not gonna be the last time you hear. It's good for them. Who's gonna upload it for 10?
You didn't plan that through, babe.
Nah, I need like contingency plans. Like, if you guys hear this, upload it. Captivate. .fm. This is all will and testament. Nobody gets shit because I'm broke. Anyway, I don't have anything else. What you got?
You're like, well, I was waiting for you because you had the whole load up. Like, I'm ready. I was like, okay, what's he gonna say?
I thought I was gonna, but I had nothing.
What do I have? Oh, race. So, this is.
Oh, you wait. Let me stop. Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead. I'll see myself out.
Yeah, see yourself way out.
I was just had a door button.
So you guys start adding those. We need more buttons.
I know. Get rid of some of these shits that we don't use. What is this? Stupid. Dumb. What else is this? That's an all right one. I be saying mad funny shit, so.
In your dreams.
But anyway, go ahead, baby.
No, so this is like, we're going to get into like a semi-serious topic. Kind of had like a little bit of an incident, or I overheard an incident that happened at my job. And basically, it's a topic of, at what point do you think it's okay for you to step in when a topic about race is happening? So you have two different people that are two different races, and they're having a conversation, and stuff starts to get kind of heated. And you're like the bystander. At what point do you think you should like step in, either to break it up or possibly?
It depends. Is the conversation heated? Is it a bad conversation, or is it fun and games? Are people laughing, or is it you, the bystander, that's uncomfortable, or is whoever's in the conversation uncomfortable?
Well, let's take it at multiple sides. So let's say the conversation is starting to get heated up. And you're the bystander, and you're seeing these two people are kind of starting to get heated up, when do you think it's appropriate for you to step in?
It depends on who it is.
Okay.
It's situational. Like, if it's two people and whatever, like, I know them and they're having a conversation and it's heated, whatever, I just let them talk. Because is it about it being about race, it being heated, or if it's just a heated discussion in general? Because I have heated discussions all the time with people. Like, if you even sit around me and Kyra for, like, 10 minutes, we're going to be cussing each other out. Like, it's just what it is. So it's like, it depends on...
It's a heated discussion about race and, like, race culture and stuff.
Be specific, because I don't, like, because like I said, it just depends on what the conversation is about, depending on if I'm intervening, because if it's not, if I don't.
And I'm trying to do it without, like, spilling too much of information out.
HIPAA.
I know. HIPAA. Basically.
All right, put another scenario then. It doesn't have to be about these people.
I know, but it's, like, hard to think about. I'm trying to think in a way. Okay, so they're just, one is white and the other one is black. And the white person is saying, is talking about black culture, but in a way that he's, like, kind of naive about it. He just kind of, not clueless, but he's, like, naive. Like, he wants to learn, but is not saying stuff that, like, at the right time of saying things. So they're starting to discuss things. It starts to get heated. At what point do you think, like, you, because you're black, at what point do you think you should step in, either, like, to defend your culture, or be able to step in and be like, okay, this is what is why we do certain things in our culture. Does that make sense?
So I'm stepping in with an opinion, not stepping in to defuse anything.
Is both. What you're saying? Yeah, so both. Like, if you're going to step in, just either do an opinion or to defuse something. Like, at what point do you feel like you should step in to defuse it?
Like I said, it depends on the people. You know what I mean? Like, it depends on the people and if I feel like it could be taken to another level. If I feel like it's just going to remain in discussion, let them discuss away. Because they're two adults. One of them has to be mature enough to be like, all right, well, we'll just table it. Like, whatever. You think your way, I think my way, boom. But if it's getting heated to the point where it's like, okay, now we're cursing each other out, or now we're yelling at each other, or we're going to fight about it, then, yeah, intervene and be like, all right, y'all, I just need to chill, whatever. Y'all got different opinions. Boom. Like, it is what it is. Chill out. But if they're just talking about it and it's heated, it's not my place to step in, because they're two grown adults, so they can have their discussion however they see fit.
Okay.
So it's not my place to, but, all right, guys, chill. You know what I mean? Like, no, let them have their discussion. If it's a healthy discussion that, you know, either needs to be had or they want to have it, then I let them have it. You know what I mean? It's not my place to either tell them what they can or can't talk about, or, like, interfere in their conversation.
Okay. So, yeah, like, for me, when it comes to, you know, culture stuff, especially, like, me being Latina, I kind of take stuff.
What?
Oh, I know what. I will stick up for my culture. I will stick up for it hardcore, no matter what. But I'm also very understanding when people want to ask certain questions. But I have more respect for people that can come up to me in a respectful way and ask me about certain things. If people just start to randomly throw things and I have no background about it, that's when I kind of feel a little bit, not like kind of, I feel a way about it, because I just feel like they're just throwing things and not really putting, like, meaningful or putting, like, respect to what they're saying.
It's funny, because this is kind of like not it's a little different, but a conversation that me and Kyra was having the other day.
Mm-hmm.
Where, like, being being a part of the black culture, okay, people feel like all black people should speak on all black matters, when that's not the case. Like, if I don't want to speak on a matter, I don't have to.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah, there's times where I will speak on black culture and what I feel is wrong or right, blah, 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 blah. But there's other times where I'm not. And, you know, I feel like people might look at you like an Uncle Tom or something. Like, if I...
Okay, let me cut you off real quick. So do you feel like you get judged by your own culture if you don't speak up about topics?
Not me personally, but I see it a lot where, okay, it's like, oh, this person, like, especially like for famous people, they expect you to be the voice. And mm-hmm. It's like, what if they don't have to? Like, I'm not looking at any famous person to be some kind of voice of reason for me. I don't care. Like, I'm not like, okay, for instance, people with the, like, LeBron versus Michael thing was like, oh, LeBron to speak up for black issues and he'll da-da-da-da-da-da. And Mike just kind of, you know, played both sides or he stayed quiet and he didn't speak on certain issues and he just, why does he have to? Like, he's a person. Like, he doesn't have to speak on certain issues, and we as people should not look toward these people. Even if they are quote-unquote role models, they don't have to speak on everything.
So the thing for me is... You know me. You know I always say action.
What?
I meant to say action, but I said
spacking. I swear you're from Texas on the low.
Probably, babe.
Them spactions.
I know. I feel like, you know me, I always say that actions speak louder than words. So I'm always looking at people's actions rather than their words. So yeah, maybe, you know, Michael isn't speaking about that, but maybe his actions are different. Maybe he's doing something that people are not seeing, but is more impactful than people just talking about it. Because right. I feel like you can always just talk about certain things, but if you're not going to put any action to the words you're doing, then why are you wasting your breath and just speaking about it? And I know, like, a lot of stuff, it's hard to do, and it's hard to be like an activism. And is it, that's the right word, right? Activism? Or activism. Mm-hmm.
Activism.
Yeah.
I believe so.
Yeah. I feel like it's,
sometimes you be so sure on your words that you confuse me. Like, I'm pretty sure it's activism.
Yeah. I just feel like some people, to do stuff like that, I feel like there's so many different ways. You don't always have to be like out in the crowd and speaking your words. Sometimes you can do stuff on the low that towards the end, it's more impactful. And it's more, you're like, oh, wow. Like, you actually made more of a difference than just using your words.
True. Yeah, I feel that too. Like, actions, like, if I, but then you got some, like, it's a whole different, like, tangent to what we started talking about. Yeah. But whatever. But like, a lot of the famous people that, like, do charitable acts, and there's always a flipping camera crew with them. It's like, okay, but how, okay, glad you did it, but yeah, how genuine was the act?
And
versus if I, you know, every Friday go to a soup kitchen and serve the homeless, or I make food and pass it out to homeless people that's on the street that I see sleeping at bus stops, but I never talk about it and never do it. Because I, like, give money to homeless people all the time, or, you know me, I give rides to people who need a ride, or da-da. I do mad charitable shit, but I'm not hopping on something or videoing it or talking about, like, and I just did this and that.
But that's a thing.
I feel good. You guys should be happy for me.
And like, this is something that I'm kind of weird about, because, like, I feel like if I'm going to do something, and this is how my mom always raised me, is that if you're going to do something for somebody, you do it because it comes out of your heart, not because you're going to get something out of it.
Right.
And that's something that I take with me anything that I do. Like, if I'm going to do something for you or for my mom or for anybody in general, I'm doing it because it comes out of my heart. Not because, oh, I want to feel that thank you tell me, or I, you know. And I think a lot of people these days are trying, they try to have it in a good way, but in reality, they're just trying to do to satisfy themselves. They're trying to figure out, okay, let's have camera people see me, like, make all these sandwiches for these people, or, you know, see me, like, I also see, like, people who are, like, famous that, you know, talk about charities that they're doing or stuff. I'm like, how much of them are actually in the work are they just speaking about it because they're famous and, you know, since they're famous, they're going to get people to, you know, to do stuff? Or are they actually doing stuff on the low that are like, you know, helping them out without having people feel them? Like, I understand what you're saying. It's like, I want to see all those people do things because it comes out of their heart, not because, oh, we're famous and we have all these followings and they're going to do it because we're telling them to do it.
Right.
So I feel like, I think a lot of things, you know, people, like I said, people do get mad because certain people are very passionate about certain things, but I feel like I respect more people that are passionate about things that don't have to put it on the social media lighting that they're doing it. Just do it because you want to do it, not because you want something out of it.
Yeah, a lot of people don't see that. Like, they just they want the they want other people to gratify their charitable acts, where it's like, no, like, just do it because it makes you feel good. Like, don't do it for other people to tell you that what you did was good. You know what I mean? But
yeah, like this whole like culture, like race stuff. Yes, there's certain things that people say that, you know, I'll see it and I'll just be like, okay, you know, whatever. But there's certain things that people might say that, you know, might hit me in a different way. And so then I might actually speak up about it. And I feel like it also, people get kind of like talked down about that because it's like, oh, now you're speaking about it. It's like, no, it's not that now I'm speaking about it. It's like this person says something that, you know, it's actually affected me in a way. Like, it might affect me personally, or I know somebody that's going through this, or, you know, it happened to somebody that, you know, I'm close to. So I feel like people also get, you know, what's the word I'm thinking of, babe? It's not talked down, but I can't think of the word. Anyways, it's like they also, those people that are just only speak about certain things that, you know, might actually trigger them, than having to speak about every single thing that pops up.
Yeah, me, I'd just be like,
backlash. That's the word I'm looking for.
Facing backlash.
Yeah.
Like, I'd just be too focused on, and it sounds selfish, but like, I'd be too focused on my life and what I need to do to survive, or what I need to do to, you know, keep my family alive, or whatever I need to do. And I can't bury myself in every negative thing that happens to a black person. Like, I can't, yeah. I can't be like, sure, do I pay attention? Do I notice it? Do I, you know, does it cross my path? Sure. But I don't need to go into back and forth conversations about it. I don't need to put my opinion on it. I don't need to, like, what's wrong is wrong, what's right is right. Now, you have those gray areas, and I think that's where I come in at, to where I'm very, I want to say the word is objectionable. Like, I look at...
You look at both sides.
I look at both sides. Like, I'm not always a one-sided person. Like, if something happens to a black person, I'm not just... Like, oh, that's fucked up. No. Like, I look at it and I be like, oh, yeah, that was fucked up. They shouldn't have did that. Like the Boham story. Like, yeah, you went into his house and shot him in his house, and you claimed you thought it was your house and thought that he was right. All right, what are you doing? Like, that's fucked up. But, like, I'm not on every story saying, like, oh, the black person was automatically in the right because they were black. But, like, you don't hear too much of that. Like, me and Kyra laugh a lot about, like, how you always have people like, nah, free da 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 da, like, free Moochie, he ain't do it, no, or free Moochie, like, he need to be free, like, he killed two people at a gas station that he was robbing, like, why should he be free? Like, why are we walking around with shirts saying free Pookie? Like, no. Like, free Pookie kidnapped the baby and murdered a grandma. Like, why should this person be free?
Okay, so do you think that a lot of people just jump on certain things because it has to do about their race instead of actually looking at the details?
Yes. Yes, I don't feel like, I don't think a lot of people do their own research sometimes. I think they see something cross their airways or they see a whole bunch of other people up in arms about it and just hop on the bandwagon versus actually looking at a story and being like, I don't know about this one, guys.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if this one's our fight. You know what I mean?
I mean, like, for me being Hispanic, like, I look at things and I like to, you know, I like to look at, like you said, like, I like to look at both sides. I want to see... What is people like? First of all, I want to see what is people making a big fuss about. I want to see that first, and then I want to get into it and start reading stuff. And sometimes it can take you to a whole different, you know, area, and you're just like, oh, okay, I'm all types of confused. But I want to see like, okay, what are people making a big fuss? And it's always hard because on social media there are so many different sides, and it's like, and then it's also what kills me, that people get mad when you have a different opinion. Like, if you jump in,
what's the saying? It's three sides to every story.
Yeah, there's their side, this side, and the truth is always coming in the middle. And I feel like people, even if you just slightly disagree with them, they will come at you. No tomato.
Because like, you can't talk today.
I can't talk today at all.
Like, yeah, because a lot of people get too stuck on their own opinion and can't be swayed. And it's like, yeah, there's a thing where it's like, you know, stand on your ground, stand on your morals. But like, if something is being, if facts are being presented to you, eventually you. If it contradicts what you think, you have to come off your stance.
Yeah.
Like me, I can be persuaded. If I'm presented with something that is... Some more YouTube exclusives in the middle of a serious conversation.
At some point, it might have covered off, so it might be chopped. It's okay.
It might be a little bit cut off, but it's cool. Eventually... Well, it works. I don't know, because, okay, guys, this is all YouTube exclusive at the moment.
Yeah.
But I have the app on my phone to where I can, like, hit record or stop or whatever, so we don't have to, like, get up and do too much of a cut. But for some reason, sometimes it just disconnects itself, and then we have to get up, because the camera only has a 30-minute recording time limit. So every 30 minutes or every 29 minutes or whatever, we try to... Start it back up, take a little pause, start it back up. But sometimes the camera app disconnects itself from the camera, and then we get into that type of situation. But it's all good. Back to the show. But yeah, so it's just like sometimes you just have to come off your stance. You can't always be what I think is right, yeah. And you can't tell me otherwise.
But thing I also like with that saying is, I'm also not a big fan of if two people have different opinions. I'm not a big fan of one person being super heavy and just trying to convince you that they are right. I'm not a big fan of that. I want to have a conversation with somebody where you can see their side, you can see my side, and let's try to find something that makes sense, so like something in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
I'm okay with us having different opinions. I'm okay with us having different, you know, it might not be the same. We might not agree to disagree. I like using that saying because sometimes we have things where we're not going to agree, and that's fine. But we also have to come together where we can see, okay, I see your side. Do you see my side?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not a big fan of people just being like, no. It's me and my side. And this is, no, you're wrong. That's like one of my big, like my biggest pet peeve is people not really truly listening to the other person and just all of a sudden just like tune them out and just like, no, I have my side, I'm right, I'm always right, you're wrong. I don't like that. I want people to have, like, it's hard to have conversations these days because one, a lot of people are really sensitive about certain things. Two, if you're trying to have a conversation, it's always you're wrong, I'm right, I did this research, I'm like, and then they start when people kill me when they try to put like statistics to things, I'm like, okay, I'm just trying to have a conversation. And they're like, no, and the New York Times bestseller, like, I don't care. Like, everybody's allowed to have opinions, and we should be century? I can't think of a word. Where you should be able to just voice what you want to say without being backlashed and thrown down into a million pieces and being like, oh no, you know what, you're a piece of shit. So
I was with you until that last sentence.
Okay.
Yes, you should have the right to say whatever you want to say, but in that same case, like, no, you shouldn't say certain things. So I just want to clarify, like, yes, you can say whatever you want to say, but you shouldn't spew racist and homophobic stuff. Like, I know. I just want to clarify. I was like, okay, you was cool into that last sentence. Yeah, like, you should be able to say whatever you want to say. I'm like, yeah, technically, no, sure, yeah, but
yes, but like. But also feel like people are going to disagree on that war and be like, no, we have the, what's the freedom of speech? And
yeah, then, and you do have the freedom of speech, but I also have the freedom of speech to be like, nah, yeah. Fuck you.
Like, also, I feel like we should have a freedom of speech, but also know people's, like, respect people at the same time. Yes, you can say what you want to say, but respect people. And I feel like we don't have that anymore. We don't have that in our culture where we can respect people's opinions. We can respect people.
Yeah.
And we don't have that anymore. It's just like, now it's like, okay, I'm going to dog you out. I'm going to say whatever you want. You're going to have to take it. And if you tell me, I'm going to shoot you. Like, at the end of the day, it's like, it just leads to violence. We can't just have
conversations. Some people can't talk. And some people have a hard time listening.
Yeah.
Some people can't communicate well.
I can't communicate well. I know that.
So some people can't put what they want to say in the words that makes sense for another person to understand. I think that's a big thing as well. Because sometimes you might be saying the same shit as someone else, but you can't. You have to be able to. It takes.
Like for us, okay. We have. On certain things, we have different topics and we have different opinions. Mm-hmm. But I feel like at the end of the day with both of us is, yes, we're both headstrong and we both, you know, are pretty much, we stick to what we're going to say. But at the same time, I feel like we respect each other to be like, okay, let me understand what you're trying to say. And you give me that time and I give you the time to tell me how you're feeling. And then at the end of the day is we both are listening to each other. I think that's the thing. We're listening to each other, what we're saying, and we're listening to the words that are coming out of our mouth. We're not just like only selecting certain words that we're saying. And I can say that I'm guilty of that when we first started dating, because there were certain things I just wasn't clicking to me, and I was stuck on certain things you were telling me, and I'm guilty of it. I can admit that now.
I ain't never did that. I'll say no.
Lies. So, but I feel like now we're to a point where, okay, yes, if we have, you know, disagreements, we can come to each other and be like, hey, this is what I was trying to say. This is what I'm trying to say. And then we can understand. I just feel like a lot of times it's just that a lot of days people now, they want to voice what they're saying and try to like pretty much like be on top of each other, like who has the louder voice and who can say it, you know, I guess the best, or, you know, I just think that we're just never listening ever.
I just think people know how to talk to certain people. That's all. Like I said, some people just can't communicate properly, and that could be can't find the right words, don't know how to, you know, speak, or, and sometimes it could be like you just don't know how to. I had the word and I lost it that quick, but just know how to. Golly, I can't think of another word to even replace the word that I can't remember. But to just know how to get your point across to where, like, you know how to communicate it so that person can understand. Because you can mean well in what you're saying, but depending on how it comes off, it could be
hurtful.
Yeah, it could be taken the wrong way, and it's like, oh no, we actually think and are saying the same thing, but the way you're putting it just doesn't mesh with me well.
Yeah, I think it goes to the other point of like choosing the words that are going to make sense without offending the other person. Mm-hmm. And that sometimes you really can't help it. Sometimes, you know, you're going to say things and you're going to be like, I mean.
Sometimes people need to hear them things.
Yeah,
though.
Like sometimes, I just feel like sometimes you can't really sugarcoat it. You gotta
be like, hey, look, I'm going to tell you some things that you ain't going to want to hear, but you need to hear them.
But you also, as the person, like I said, if you're telling me that, I'm going to respect you more because you're telling me the truth. You're not going to sugarcoat it. Mm-hmm. And I feel like a lot of people can't do that nowadays. I feel like a lot of people want sugarcoated versions of the actual truth.
No, I just be like, just keep it real with me. Don't sugarcoat it. Don't beat around the bush. Don't make me think something is that isn't. Like, just keep it real. That's the best way. If everybody kept it real, there would be no problems, because then you would know who was on what side. You would know who thinks what. You would know everyone's true intentions and behavior if everyone was just up front.
See, I don't know. I have a weird relationship with the word real, because I feel like a lot of people use it, but they don't really use it in a way that it should be used.
How do you mean?
I don't know. Like, for me, because I've had this discussion with my best friend Edith, and we both kind of we've kind of had like the same like thought about it. I feel like real is something that, for at least for me, is the word. If I'm going to use the word real, I'm going to use it for like an object. Like, this is real. This is fake.
Something that's tangible.
Yeah. And I feel like a lot of people use it to be like, nah, I'm a real one, and I'm this. And I'm just like, no, you should use more words like I'm genuine, or other words than just saying real.
But let's be real here. When people say today, oh, I'm a real one, they're just masking their insecurities. Yeah. But so whenever someone says, like, I'm a real one, and blah, 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 like, no, you're not. Shut up.
Yeah, that's
you're hurt right now, yeah. So now that's why you're saying these things.
Like, that's where we, like, Edith and I
guess when I said be real, not proclaim that you're a real one, just do it. Just be real. Just always be honest and upfront, and just like not lie and sugarcoat. Like, just always be who you are.
Yeah, but that's like, that's where where it kind of rubs me the wrong way when I hear, you know, especially these youngins, they be saying, oh, I'm a real one. I'm a real bitch. I'm this. I'm just like, there's other words.
Real ass bitch.
I just think there should be other words to describe yourself that you're trying to use instead of just using the word real. Because I feel like
it's just slang and ghetto. Because if someone says, I am a very genuine female and I deserve to, like, it just, you know.
Yeah, I mean,
no one's going to talk like that. So they'd be like, I'm a real bitch.
I mean, true. But I don't know. It just, for me, I'm just like, there's other ways we can describe it. And I feel like the word real gets thrown a lot, and I just feel like there should be other ways of describing yourself. And
you gotta come on with it, baby. You start the trend.
I know.
Do it. So yeah, look, our short podcast turned into an hour and a half, so let's get the hell out of here.
And that's another episode of
But what am I about to say? Oh, of course, we ended up filming late today because, well, she had to work, and then I was doing DoorDash. But I mean, either way, if I wasn't doing DoorDash, she was still at work, so we got home at the same time, so it wouldn't have mattered. We could have done it in the morning, but that's whack. So
wiggity wiggity whack.
Because I feel like you haven't worked on a Saturday in quite a while, so like it just worked out to like where we just film on Saturdays. Like, I feel like you haven't worked on a Saturday in like 2 months. So
no, I have. It just I think it just feels a lot longer because I have to go to work at 1 now instead of working at 5. So we have like most of the afternoon before I have to go to work, and then I come back and it's like, oh, I was only gone for 4 hours instead of being gone for 8.5 hours. So it just seems a lot longer. You know, I be working my Saturdays.
All right, you did work a Saturday that day. That was a couple weeks ago. Went to Jungle Gyms, but I made that lamb and steak.
Yeah.
So yeah, okay, you ain't bullshitting.
I don't do that.
But guys, I believe this is the conclusion to episode 8.
Yeah.
Ooh. Boom, boom, boom.
I need one of those.
We do not. We are not putting that on the board. We are not getting one of those dance hall horns.
Sad face.
You gotta just do it by mouth each time. Come on, pout it. But all right, guys, thank you guys for listening and watching and just supporting us. We appreciate it. We liking it. I'll be showing my baby the numbers and I'll be like, oh, I'm happy about this number. She'll be like, I don't know what the numbers mean, but I'll be like, I'm happy about it. Yeah. So
I'll be like, cool, babe. I'm proud.
So, yeah, just keep supporting us and we'll be back every Monday at 6 a.m. You know, for you guys to go to work, even though I don't know if most of you guys are even going to work right now. But you can just listen to it, you know, at home, you know, wherever. Go for a ride and just listen to us. We'll give you a good hour each week, at least, maybe, most of the time.
If we want episode, we're like, yeah, we got 10 minutes of this.
I thought it was going to be today. I was just like, yeah, fuck this. This ain't really hitting.
It's because I had the good talk.
You got to keep talking. Once you keep talking, you fall into a good conversation eventually.
See, I got you, babe. I got that conversation. I was like, aha, I know what I thought this one at.
Will we play baseball now?
Yeah, exactly. Look, babe, I know what you like. You love baseball.
I do love baseball, but don't remind me that baseball season hasn't started yet. We're damn near middle of freaking May. And
look, soccer hasn't started yet either, and I'm a little sad. I don't cry.
Yeah.
Don't cry.
But guys,
I mean, I guess you shouldn't cry. I mean, you should cry because you know your Reds would have still lost a lot of games. You know,
you're an FC Cincinnati fan, so I don't fucking care about what you got to say. They won 2 games last year.
I think they only won 1 technically.
It was like 1-19 or something.
Yeah.
My Bengals was what 2-14, so
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, Bengals.
But we got Joe Burrow's now. I don't think they're gonna do nothing this year, but hopefully they can build a team around them.
Can they That'd even cool. play this year?
This is true too. Who knows if any sports is gonna play? Basketball. I need my sports guys. I'm kind of jonesing right now. I haven't seen a sport in like 2-3 months.
Because
you're
not watching the old classics, you know, the 2016.
I'm getting tired of that. That's all on TV right now. Let's watch Kobe's last game for the 15th time. I love Kobe, but even now, I've seen that game at least 4 or 5 times in my life now. And I'm good. They was playing, I was in one of them restaurants today. They were playing the ALCS of baseball. It was Boston against New York. I'm like, okay.
But you
keep playing
you
all these old sports.
You didn't know that tennis is coming back. Apparently, they're going to have the reopening of the opening.
Well, tennis is like one of the only sports that can actually be played because, well, baseball as well. I feel like baseball could be played because they're so spread out there. The only people that are kind of close is if you're on a base, first base, and, you know, second base, the people are kind of close. But they're far out. And tennis, they're like 50 feet away. So, like, they can definitely play tennis without an audience. But they can definitely play.
Could you imagine playing baseball without an audience? Oh, you hit a ball and you're like,
it's going to be trash.
The announcer's going to be saying something. Oh, and he'd be like,
it's a long one. And no one's even.
They're going to start playing, like, the sounds of people cheering.
It's going to be like on sitcoms where they got to add in the. It's going to be like, oh, wrong one. They're going to add this in. You'd be like, that doesn't sound real. It's the same cheer every time. Like, yeah, it is. So yeah, hopefully some sports come back. Go ahead.
What's the one guy that does like the plays on the organ when he's like dun 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 dun? Yeah, he's gonna do that. He's gonna be like, I'm tired of the job. They're just gonna have
no one's gonna say charge.
They're gonna have charge, but it's gonna be on a button. Everyone's gonna be all computerized.
My robot's my charge.
It's like alert.
So yeah, hopefully some sports comes back, but I mean in a safe manner. So I know the NBA been talking about playing games with no audience.
That's
I mean
be
they were just
cool.
having boxing matches today. So I'm like, how the hell are you boxing?
I mean, I feel like boxing
is
okay.
Spit corona in someone's mouth. Oh, you're gonna punch me and I'm gonna have corona in my eye. Like, I don't know.
Ew.
So yeah, I don't know.
I just thought about that. That's gross.
But they got the referee in there with a damn mask on. I was looking at this shit like, I was like, what the hell am I watching? The referee got a mask on, but the two boxers are just like sharing blood, sweat, and tears and saliva. I'm
no,
like,
the,
okay.
The referee's gonna have a whole like hazmat suit on. Like,
it was ridiculous. I was like, what? This referee has a mask on. Like, all right, why are they even here? But all right, guys, we're getting about here for real.
For real, for real.
For real, for real. For real, for real. So, go ahead. We're going to bid you guys adieu.
Yeah. Yeah.
You gotta say adieu.
Oh, adieu. Sorry, my bad. I was gonna do dab, but we're not on YouTube.
Well, I mean, we are technically okay. If you wanted to go dab for the YouTube people. My drink's dusty. Anyway. See you later, guys. Guys and girls out there.
You sound really creepy when you say that. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, guys. I won't be creepy anymore.
Lies.
I'm sorry. Bye. 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 Bye.